Welcome back, it's Millie Cockapoo. For those of you who don't already know, Millie is my first dog, and this video is going to be on some of the things I would do differently if I could go back to 10 months ago when she first came home. It's important to mention that every dog is different and everyone has different preferences when it comes to training your dog. What one dog might respond to doesn't mean another dog would respond the same way. A lot of training is about being consistent and persistent and doing a lot of research. But these are just a couple of things that I would alter or do slightly differently if I could go back. First up, I wouldn't give in to Millie as quickly with her eating habits. Especially during the first few months, I would give in to her when she was being fussy, and that meant we tried a few different types of food. If I could go back, I would stick to the advice I was given when Millie was about 6 months old, about being persistent and not giving in and not giving them anything else to subsidise their food, because then they're not going to eat because they just presume you're going to give them something better. I have done a full video on this, which I will link above and down below if you would like to go watch it. But I definitely wish I'd known that advice sooner, as we probably wouldn't have tried so many different types of food. The second thing I would do differently would be starting puppy classes sooner. This was something that was out of our control because of COVID. She was originally meant to start them when she was 16 weeks old, but because of lockdown, they all got delayed and she ended up being about 8 months old when we could go on them, which meant that she already knew everything that they were teaching on the puppy course. And I didn't really gain anything from it because I'd had to teach her everything and do my own research. Whereas if we'd gone on them when she was 16 weeks old, we would have gained a lot from them. That was just one of those things that I couldn't help but we went back into lockdown. I had the best intentions by booking her on the course. But if you've got a puppy now and you're umming and ahhing about going on the puppy classes, I definitely recommend them. But go as young as you possibly can. If possible, go when they're 12 weeks old and they've just had all their injections and they can go out into the world. That is the best time when you'll both get the most out of the classes. The next thing I wish I'd done differently is relating to her grooming. If you've seen the grooming videos, then you know that I wish that she would have gone to puppy grooms first, but I also wish that I'd done more grooming with her from a young age. I probably did a little bit of grooming with Millie maybe every 3 to 4 days. It wasn't that often. Honestly, she didn't mat when she was a young puppy because of the puppy fur. It was only as she got a bit older that I noticed I need to start doing it a bit more. Whereas if I'd been brushing her from the day she'd come home on a regular basis, she might enjoy being brushed a bit more than what she does at the moment. Next, I wish I'd started practicing heel sooner. I waited until Millie was between 16 and 18 weeks old to start training this, just so she could get used to the surroundings and not have that as much of a distraction. But I think this definitely put her back by a few weeks, potentially. And with everything, I think you're just better off starting it sooner rather than later. I don't think you can ever start training them too soon, and it definitely would have made the walks during those first few months a lot easier if we'd been practicing heel. Next is something that we're still working on because of how quickly I rushed her into it. She is petrified of it, and that is the hairdryer. After her first bath, I was coaxing her with chicken and then I just turned it on and blew it on her. And I think a lot of people will do the same thing because you're just like, I need to get this dog dry as quick as possible. I don't want him to get cold. And now she absolutely hates it. And I don't use it on her now. I've tried to take it right back to basics and just have her in the room with me if I'm drying my own hair. But if the door's open, she will definitely bolt out of the room. If I could go back, I would have had the hairdryer blowing in the vicinity for a few days prior to actually putting it on her. And I don't think she would have freaked out as much then. And the next thing on my list is personal preference. As everything that I read was completely different. Some people said that you should have your dog sleeping near you the first few nights so that they're not as scared. Other people said to put them in the room that you want them from that first night. So I chose to have Millie up in my room with me in her crate. And honestly, I did not sleep at all that night. Every movement she made kept me up, because I was petrified of her having an accident. And then the one time I did drop to sleep, she pooed in a crate. Whereas I think I would have slept better, and then the following night I did sleep better, just having her in the crate in the kitchen and having the camera on motion detection, so I'd been notified if she was restless, and then also setting alarms for every couple of hours. That one's just personal preference, and I think I would have slept a lot better, and I wouldn't have felt as run down those first few weeks if I hadn't have had such a bad night's sleep that first night. And the final thing on my list is I wish I'd not compared her and her progress to other dogs of similar age as much. Having an Instagram account for your dog is amazing. You get to make friends, and there's a positive community of other crazy dog mums on there, and you can speak to people with the same type of dog as you at similar stages in their life and get advice, and it is very beneficial, that platform. But like any social media, you end up comparing yourself to them, and you need to remember that in most cases, accounts only put up the best part of the dog, so they don't show all the negative. So some accounts might be showing that the dogs are doing amazingly well at some tricks, but they're not showing all the bad things that the dog's at, or where it's not at in progress. And you can really get yourself into a rut comparing yourself and your dog to those other dogs, being like, well, my dog's 16 weeks and they can only do 10 tricks, yet that dog is 12 weeks and they can do 20 tricks. Well, your 10 tricks might be on both a verbal cue and a signal, whereas the other dog could be doing 20 tricks only with a love still. I can't say that word, but you know what I mean. People count things differently, and you just need to remember that. And some dogs pick up things quicker than others. Don't let comparison be the thief of your joy. Is that the quote? Yeah, I feel like I'm trying to get a bit deep there, but yeah, that is the biggest advice to anyone I can give if you're getting a dog, is just don't compare yourself. That's the last item on my list. I've probably got a few more as well, but I just can't think of them at the moment. And I think as a first-time owner, as my training abilities develop and I understand Millie more, there's a lot of stuff that I would change looking back. I'd be interested to know if there's any mistakes that you made or things that you do differently if you could go back to the early stages of having your dog. I think everyone, if they admit it, would do something slightly differently if they could go back. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure you like it. If you don't already, then please go and follow us over on Instagram at Millie a Cockapoo, and please subscribe so you won't miss a video from us, and we will see you next week. Bye.